Okay, we talked about when the horse develops, the shoulder gets wider. What actually happens behind the shoulder where the saddle sits? A horse develops from a flat A to a pointy A into a bell shape on the withers. Next time you lead your horse or ask a friend to lead your horse, and put your horse right on top of the withers. Maybe put it back 3-4 inches and just straddle his withers with your hand and walk beside him. Close your eyes, watch where you're going, and you actually can feel how the wither muscle widens. So if my hands would be his withers, what actually happens in motion, this happens. Okay? Why wouldn't the back muscle widen? Why wouldn't the back go this way? Well, when the back muscle contracts, just like your bicep contracts, gets bigger, the horse would rear or buck. So most of the time we want that back muscle nice and loose so that you don't see any large widening on the bottom, more where the muscle pulls, the trapezius, the spinalis, and the rhombi, that's where you feel the movement. So here we have Kathy. Kathy is our horse, and when I say, can you please move, horse? So again, when the horse moves, you can feel on top of the withers how it's wide. So stop. What the horse does at the withers, it widens on top and narrows while the horses move. So keep in mind that the tree angle, we talked about tree width first, keep in mind that the tree angle could be a wide angle, medium, or narrow. So my horse here looks like it has a medium angle, so I put a medium tree angle on top. Now I'm going to ask my horse Kathy to move. She can't move her fingertips away. So stop. So the first inclination is, if it's too tight on top, why don't we just widen the angle? If I widen the angle, the weight would come down, and then all the pressure's against the side. Can you move, horse? There's no way.
No.
You see how the bottom of the hand wants to widen, and the bottom of the hand represent the back muscle, the longissimus dorsi. So when that tightens, when the back muscle tightens, only when the horse rears or bucks. So we don't want that. So how can we fit the saddle? The saddle needs to sit flush on top of the longissimus dorsi, has to have room here on top. Now she can move. Thank you. So let me show you on the slide how this should look like when you go to your horse to check your saddle. When a horse matures at 3 years, you can see how wide the shoulders are. At 5 years, the shoulders get wider, and then at 8 years, the shoulders are really wide. So just like on human beings, is when we work out and we lift weights, our shoulders get wider, and has nothing to do just with the age. It has something to do with how we train. And on the horse, when the shoulders get wider, that relates to the tree width, because the shoulders move 6 to 8 inches underneath and through the saddle. Tree width. At the three-year-old, right behind the shoulder where the saddle or the gullet plate sits, what happens when the horse matures, the withers comes up and that flat A on the top becomes a more pointier withers. All of us who had young horses and ridden it say, all of a sudden my horse started to get withers. So it's a definition of the muscle group. And then at eight-year-old, he will have, instead of a flat A, almost more like a bell shape withers. You see the gullet plate stayed the same, and you see how much it pinches now. So underneath the saddle, behind the shoulder, that's where tree angle is very important. So it doesn't pinch on the top, that it sits flush right here on the longissimus, but it has space for this muscle groups to expand. As we learned earlier, that's where you feel and see the wither muscle moving. So you want that space. So if I have to choose which is the best fit, definitely here, because we can see there's the muscle what expands and needs to get wider. This only expands if the horse rears or bucks. Thank you.
Thank you.